Well, hello, friends. It's Amy Frilici at the Gathering Inspiration Stamp Studio. And today, check out this beautiful card, all the sparkly blue on it. Kind of shifted in the light so you can see the embossing, the beautiful detail on the glimmer paper, the super fun shiny ribbon, all part of, I'm going to show you in the catalog, it's called the Snowflake Splendor Suite from our August to December mini catalog. So basically, I call it the holiday catalog. But on pages, we're going to start on page 36 and 37. You can see the full suite. So here you can see, oh my gosh, look at the Snowflake Splendor. Just beautiful, right? Kind of almost makes you wish for winter, maybe. I don't know. Not really around here quite yet. But we have gorgeous, this is the Snowflake Splendor Designer Series paper. I actually didn't use this on this particular project, but the paper itself is beautiful. We used everything else on this page though. So we used the Snowflake Wishes Bundle. I will show you that a little bit larger size on the next page. We used the Winter Snow Embossing Folder, the Balmy Blue Glimmer Paper, the Blue Adhesive Backed Gems, those are beautiful, and then the Snowflake Splendor Ribbon. That is kind of an iridescent ribbon, so super pretty. It kind of pulls whatever colors you put it with. The best part about this is everything on this page that I just showed you can be ordered with one item code. You get everything. It's $94.75 to basically get all of this product. You do get the bundle at the 10% discount as well. So it's an awesome, easy way to just put your order in, get everything that you want right in that suite, including, here's a better view of the stamp set. So the Snowflake Wishes stamp set. Can you see? Look at all of the snowflakes you can stamp in this stamp set. And then you also have great sentiments like Snowflake Wishes for a Merry Christmas. May your season sparkle. In the coldest moments of the year, my heart is warm because you're near. Thank you so much. Our friendship is one of a kind. And then they also put in a happy Hanukkah in case that's something that you need. And then over here are the so many snowflakes dies. I was going to say that the snow many, but it's not. It's the so many snowflakes dies. So these two, the stamp set and the dies, are bundled together, and then you get your 10% off too. So beautiful suite of products that we are featuring on our card today. So let's go ahead and get started. We have lots and lots of fun to be had in making this card, okay? So let me give you some dimensions, first of all. I'm gonna show you. We have, this is a Knight of Navy card base. So we originally have our cardstock, right? Our full sheet of Knight of Navy cardstock. Along the 11 inch side, we cut it at 5.5 inches. And then along the 8.5 inch side, we scored it at 4.25 inches, okay? That makes our nice crisp fold on our card, right? Next, we have a piece of Misty Moonlight cardstock that measures 4 inches by 5.25 inches. And then on the inside, I did the exact same, a piece of Whisper White, also measuring 4 inches by 5.25 inches. And then we just have basically some scraps of Whisper White and then our new Balmy Blue Glimmer Paper. Isn't that beautiful? I am in total love with this glimmer paper. It is just gorgeous. Perfect for those snowflakes, I thought. So, okay, let's see, what are we gonna do? Let's do our stamping. So we've got our Snowflake Wishes for a Merry Christmas on the outside sentiment. And then I used, in the coldest moments of the year, my heart is warm because you're near. I put that on our Whisper White piece on the inside. So let's do the stamping and then we can do our die cutting and embossing and put this fabulous card together. Okay, so we're gonna start, we've got Misty Moonlight ink. We're gonna just open that guy up. We are gonna do our nice, easy tap, tap, tap. Press straight down, lift straight up on our scrap of Whisper White, and then we'll put our sentiment for the inside. And this is good. We'll stamp this and then kind of set it aside. It doesn't really take long for the ink to dry, but sometimes I do kind of like to just set it over in the corner until we're ready to use that, okay? So now we can scoot our ink and stamps out of the way. We are gonna grab our brand new, oh my goodness, have you guys seen, have you played, do you have one of these yet? If you're a demonstrator, you can order it. If not, you can get the starter kit and order it. And actually tomorrow, well, depending on when I post this video, I'm doing the video right now on August 31st, so that's why I said tomorrow. But September 1st, you can order the new Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine. Beautiful, sleek, awesome new machine that we have. So All right, we are going to use, so for this we need to use our platform number one and then platform number two because we're gonna do our embossing first, okay? No, I'm sorry, we don't need platform number two. Scratch that, we just need platform number one for our embossing. And then let's see where we have the embossing folder right here, the winter snow embossing folder, okay? We are gonna slip in our piece of Misty Moonlight cardstock right inside here. Okay, so we're gonna pop that right in there. And then we are going to use our plate number three, both of them, one underneath and one on top. And then we just crank our handle. Sorry, that's probably gonna do a little wiggle wiggle. Okay, stop that for a moment. And let's check this out, because it's so pretty. Let's see, there we go. So you guys can kind of see that beautiful snowflake embossing. What I love about this is you can, like if you're having like a little winter or holiday party, you can use this embossing folder and like emboss your napkins if you want, like your little party napkins, super cute, fun little added extra to your napkins. You could just do the corner of the napkin. You could do, I guess if they're small enough, you could do the full napkin, right? But lots of fun ideas. I love the cobweb too, the spider web one. You can do that for Halloween parties also. Okay, so now back to our die cutting. We do need our kind of extra plate number two to do our die cutting to get the correct thickness. We are selling a magnetic platform as well, and that is going to be available on September 1st too. So very cool. Right, so that's why I don't have it yet, but we'll be getting it shortly. We are going to use, these are the So Many Snowflake. I'm so gonna say that, So Many Snowflake dies. So you can see this beautiful set of dies, right? We're gonna use this detailed, one right here. I'm gonna pop that down. And then we also have some more dies. So we're gonna use this one and this one to get all of our detail. And then on our sentiment, we are, let's get those things, and I forget, I don't have the magnetic plate, so it's not kind of pulling, moving things around on me, which is good in some ways, right? Okay, so then we have, these are the Hippo and Friends dies, so you can see the little hippo and then his friends, right? The labels are what I cannot get over. I love all of the label dies in here. So we are actually gonna use this, kind of the in-between, the medium size label die is what we're gonna use for our sentiment. So we're just gonna lay that down. Now, because I don't have the magnetic platform, it's good and bad, right? It's not winging things around, but it's also not holding it in place quite as well as maybe I would like, but I think we're gonna be all right. So, okay, cranking the handle again here. Sorry, we're like kind of shaking all over the place. Give me one sec. Okay, there we go. All right, so check this out. We've got that great die right there. And there's actually like a little bit of embossing, like a little ridge. I don't know if you can see that, but it adds just a little bit of texture there. And then let's get our, so these, that one's stuck in there. Okay. See if we can get these popped out. Okay. So there's one snowflake, right? And then it's almost easier. There we go. Should have thought of that. It's almost easier to see it from the back side. There we go. Okay, and then our next snowflake, and then I think the little one was still in. There we go. Pop him right out, and we've got our little snowflake right there. Okay, so we're gonna just scoot all of that right out of the way. We do not need that. And, okay, we kind of went askew there, didn't we? So, all right, I think we are ready to put things together. We have a little bit of, I forgot my paper piercing tool, but those little babies, if you kind of bend it, you see how those just popped right out. So look at that beautiful snowflake, right? So we've got, I'm like flinging stuff all over the place. These we need to pop out too, because we have to have all that detail, right? Okay, so there's the little baby snowflake, right? And then one more, and I think that is good. And then there is, I've got one more. Yeah, I guess I need to flip it over. I can see it better. There's the last snowflake. So aren't those beautiful? Like check out the, just all of the glittery beautifulness of those snowflakes. Okay, so we'll scoot those up there. We are going to grab, this is the, what are we calling this again? The Snowflake Splendor. It's an iridescent ribbon. So can you see It's like rainbow color almost, right? So we just need a strip of it. We're just going to kind of run that along our card front, and then we're going to just tack it along the back. Okay, so that's all we need there. So let's do that. We are just going to run it kind of about through the middle. I put it a little bit lower than middle so that I have enough room for my big snowflakes up on the top. And I'm going to use, this is my Stampin' Seal Plus, because this ribbon is pretty, what do I want to say? Stiff. The ribbon is pretty stiff. So I want to make sure it stays tacked on the back. And then also, because we have this embossed piece, I'm just going to keep using my Stampin' Seal Plus because that's going to help hold this on a little bit better than maybe our regular Stampin' Seal. Always with an embossed piece, like it kind of makes it rumply, like it's a little bit harder to keep it on there well and not have it like popping up and off. So I'll just use my regular Stampin' Seal for the inside of our card. So our sentiment can go right inside here. In the coldest moments of the year, my heart is warm because you're near. What a beautiful sentiment, right? Love to receive a card that said something like that. Okay, we're going to add some dimensionals back behind our sentiment. And I like to do that kind of top and bottom because I'm going to get my ribbon kind of running about through the middle. If you only do like one and two, they tend to, you know, if you put them right there and there, I always end up with them right on the ribbon and then it kind of is wobbly. So this is one where I like to use a few more. So we're going to pop that right on there. And then, and I forgot my little silicone mat. So we're just going to use the back of our dimensionals. So I'm going to add some adhesive to my snowflakes, but I don't want to get this sticky. So this is kind of a little trick. If you forget your silicone mat, just use the back of your dimensionals because it's kind of the same idea. Okay, so then we are going to add, we're going to put one snowflake right about there. Actually, I feel like I've got some adhesive on there, but I think I want a little bit more. We're going to put another snowflake right about there. And then the last big guy, and that's why I moved it down just a little bit. So I made sure this thing wasn't hanging over the edge of our card, right? Okay, then we are almost there, ladies. Last step is to add just a little bit more sparkle. I have used so many of these. These are the blue adhesive backed gems. So we've got some kind of, I don't even know the colors. They tell you in the catalog. Maybe we could peek, because I think they say one of them is navy. Now am I going to be able to read it? Balmy blue. Yeah. Okay. So we've got balmy blue right here. We've got kind of some small and some large ones. And then these are calling Night of Navy, but they're really kind of an iridescent. Also, can you see all the different colors you can pick up? These are more of a true just single color, but these have so many, like they're just so faceted and beautiful. So we are going to use, what did I do? I think I actually did kind of a multitude or an array. So I used my, like a large Night of Navy one there. I used a smaller Night of Navy one. We're going to put that right on there. And then we're going to use a larger balmy blue on that one. And then a smaller balmy blue on that one right there. And I'm going to press down, make sure those are all on there. And that's it. So do you see how kind of quick and simple and easy that is? But look at just all of the beautiful, oh, I love the shimmeriness of that balmy blue glimmer paper. It's beautiful, right? And then the awesome sentiment on the inside. So ladies, I hope you enjoyed this card today. I hope you were inspired today. I will have all of the item codes, everything that we used on this card is going to be in the details to the YouTube video right down below here. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not done that already. I will be posting this over on my blog too at gatheringinspiration.com. And just so everybody knows, I do Facebook Live videos most every single Friday afternoon on the Gathering Inspiration Stamp Studio Facebook group. So if you're not already a member over there, hop on over to that group and ask to become a member. Check out my Facebook Live videos. When you order online through me and use the host code that I show you on Facebook Live, that's also on my blog at gatheringinspiration.com, you always get two free cards from me that I demonstrate on Facebook Live with at least a $30 order, and your name goes into a Facebook Live drawing that I do every single Facebook Live for free, awesome product. So check that out. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I hope that you enjoyed this card today, and we'll see you again soon. Bye, everybody. Thank you.